arrangement of capacitors. Two bulbs are there, we can arrange according to our convenience. Two cells are there, we can arrange according to our convenience. Two resistors are there, according to convenience we can arrange. Generally arrangements are two types. There are two types of geometrical arrangements of electrical devices. Series arrangement, parallel arrangement. Series arrangement of cells, series arrangement of bulbs, series arrangement of resistors, series arrangement of capacitors. Similarly, parallel arrangement of cells, parallel arrangement of bulbs, parallel arrangement of capacitors, parallel arrangement of resistors. Now, whenever in an electrical circuit, two or more capacitors are there, you want to connect those capacitors in our convenience. Sometimes you can arrange the capacitors in a series arrangement. Sometimes you can arrange the capacitors in parallel arrangement. Sometimes you can arrange as a both. In that circuit, series arrangement of capacitors are there, parallel arrangement of capacitors are there. Now here, when the capacitors are connected in series, what is the effective capacitance? What is the resultant capacitance? Whenever the capacitors are connected in parallel, what is the effective capacitance? What is the resultant capacitance? Now in this topic we will discuss, calculate the resultant capacity, effective capacity in series arrangement as well as in the parallel arrangement. Now, one side I will calculate series arrangement, second side I will calculate parallel arrangement. Now, this is two portions. Here in this case, series arrangement of capacitors. Series arrangement of capacitors. Next one, parallel arrangement of capacitors. Parallel arrangement of capacitors. Now, series arrangement of capacitors. First capacitor. This is the first capacitor. This is the second capacitor. Now this is the third capacitor. This is the third capacitor. Now in this case, this is the first capacitor, this is the second capacitor, now this is the third capacitor. Now, first capacitor, second capacitor, third capacitor. Here the capacitance is C1. Here capacitance is C2, capacitance is C3. Here is also capacitance is C1, capacitance is C2, capacitance is C3. Now, first capacitor, second capacitor, third capacitor. First plate, second plate. Now in the series arrangement, in an electrical circuit, two or more capacitors are there. The second plate of the first capacitor is connected to the first plate of the second capacitor. Second plate of the second capacitor is connected to the right? First plate of the third capacitor and go on connecting. Finally, close the circuit. This arrangement is called series arrangement of cell, series arrangement of capacitors. In an electrical circuit, two or more capacitors are available in the circuit. See, the second plate of the first capacitor is connected to the first plate of the second capacitor. Second plate of the second capacitor is connected to the first plate of the third capacitor and go on connecting. Finally, close the circuit by the battery or cell. Then such arrangement is called series arrangement. Now here in the parallel arrangement, first capacitor, second capacitor, third capacitor. Right, now first plate. Now there is a point. Two or more capacitors are available in the electrical circuit. All the first plates are connected to a common point. What is the common point? A. First plate is connected to A. First plate of the third capacitor is also connected to A. Right, now there is another common point, B. Second plate is connected to B. Now, finally, close the circuit with the battery. Right, if two or more capacitors are available in the circuit, all the first plates are connected to a common point, all the second plates are connected to another common point, then finally close the circuit with the battery, then such an arrangement is called parallel arrangement of capacitors. Now, what is the potential? V is the potential of the battery. Right? C1, C2, C3 are arranged in a series. What is the effective capacitance? Cs. C1, C2, C3 are arranged in parallel. What is the effective capacitance? Cp. Now, here, what is the total charge? What is the energy provided by the cell? What is the charge provided by the cell? That is Q. Here, what is the charge provided by the cell? Q. Now, here in this case, right? For the charge, there is a unique flow. Single flow. Now this point is called A. Now this is point B. Between the two terminals, what is the potential? V. For the charge, it has a unique flow. Therefore, here the charge Q. Between these two terminals, what is the potential? V. Between these two terminals, the potential is V1. Between these two terminals, the potential is V2. Between these two terminals, the potential is V3.